from a Highland Broadway, broadcasting across the nation and around the world, it's The Late Show with David Letterman. Tonight, Lindsay Lohan, comedian Pete Lee, music from Gary Clark Jr., and a top 10 list with 10 area accountants, plus Paul Schaefer and the CBS Orchestra.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. Welcome to the show, Hawaii My Ass. You know what I'm saying? The hit show here on CBS every Sunday night, Hawaii My Ass. What? Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful day in New York City. Isn't it lovely here? Oh. 79 degrees and sunny, like Kelly Ripa.
Ah!
You know, everything great happens here in New York City, and occasionally something weird and peculiar. You know what I'm talking about? You take your kids down to Times Square, and you're showing them around. Anybody been to Times Square? Yeah. That's where you want to spend your honeymoon. Hawaii. Who cares? So they got a guy down there, and he's a Cookie Monster, you know, the Sesame Street character, and the big Cookie Monster, and, hey, kids, come on over and have some cookies.
Yes.
And so parents say, oh, look, it's a Cookie Monster, and then the idea is you take the kid's picture with a Cookie Monster, and so that's what they did, and he's holding the kid, oh, I'm a Cookie Monster. And so then they were late. Apparently, you're supposed to tip the Cookie Monster. I had no idea. Ah, here you go. Nice job. Thanks. So dad, while mom's getting the kid back, dad's late with the gratuity for the Cookie Monster. And the Cookie Monster pushes the kid. Pushes the kid. Oh, my God. Regis, Regis, Regis. What? Pushes. Nothing is. Guess what else? You know what's back, ladies and gentlemen? Take a guess. You know, Paul? Cicadas.
Oh, I know those things.
Cicadas are back. And this is one of those insects. Now, there's a couple of kinds. This is one of those insects that you hear that noise that drives you nuts. And they come up out of the ground every... And they have sex once every 17 years. Cicadas having sex. And I thought, great! The insects are doing better than I am. That's... They come into the city, they destroy everything, they have sex and leave. It's like Charlie Sheen, for the love of God. Hey, college basketball fans, congratulations. The Louisville Cardinals, your NCAA national champion. If you're keeping stats about this at home, this is the second time in a month that a bunch of Cardinals have gotten together and took care of business.
How about that? Okay. Yes, I remember the other time.
Well, come on, it's all right. Quite a game. I'm going to tell you something. It's quite a game. At 1 point at halftime, and Louisville ended up winning 82-76. And CBS now has put together this highlight package of all of the exciting moments during the tourney. I hope you enjoy this. Watch.
All set for the championship matchup. Unreal. Louisville to take the lead. There's the lob to Seba. Puts up the shot. And he hits it.
There prepared was wonderful, wasn't it? We were talking to some newlyweds minute ago, and listen to this. I don't know if you kids took advantage of this, but you can now, Denny's, the restaurant chain Denny's, has wedding chapels. So you can go in there and get the grand slam and get married, or you get married and then have the grand slam, you know what I'm saying? Well, not only can you get married in Denny's, but other restaurants, other fast food restaurants, heard about the Denny's wedding chapels and have branched out. Isn't that crazy?
It is nuts.
You're not going to believe this. Take a look.
You can now plan an affordable wedding at participating Denny's restaurants. But what happens if it's not meant to be? Come get your divorce at IHOP. And that's not all. IHOP now offers a full menu of marriage-related services. Estate planning, retirement strategies, marriage counseling, sex therapy, vasectomy, tax preparation, vasectomy reversal, funeral arrangements, and pancakes. So stop by I Hope Is Missed a Bit Pimperfat. Come hungry. Leave with a vasectomy.
Exactly what I'm talking about, you see? You know who's on the program tonight? Lindsay Lohan is on the show tonight. I believe it's part of her community service. All day long, people have been coming up to me and they're saying, Dave, why is Lindsay Lohan on the show tonight? And I said, I think she believes I'm Dr. Phil. I think that's why, she's here. If she actually shows up, I owe Paul $50. This is interesting. You know, when you're a president of the United States, when you leave office, you get your own presidential library. And the George W. Bush Presidential Library is opening the first week in May. Mm-hmm. It's fantastic. No expense has been spared on the George W. Bush Presidential Library. It's unbelievable. Watch this.
The George W. Bush Presidential Library and Museum is a premier destination for researchers, students, and families alike. The museum features over 100,000 artifacts and dozens of interactive activities that let you pretend to be the president. Trip. Bump your head. Trip again. Dodge a shoe. Drop a dog. And spit on the White House lawn. The George W. Bush Presidential Library and Museum. The only missing ingredient is you.
You see? Now we're having fun. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Paul Schaefer. Gentlemen, we'll be right back. Nice to have you here. Thank you very much.
Just ahead, a special top 10 list with 10 area accountants and Lindsay Lohan. And now, kitchen utensil shout out, whisks. Stick around.
America's mighty, mighty party and show band.
We're here.
We got a show for you tonight. I'm telling you, this is a show. This is why God invented TV. I'm telling you.
Tonight.
Just want to do a final recap of the NCAA tournament. Did you fill out your brackets, Paul?
Fill them out?
Yeah, I got a call from the guy at NBC Sports, and he said, Dave, a lot of people, all they care about is brackets. And there's two kinds of people that really enjoy the March Madness, which, of course, is always followed by April alcoholism.
Well,
You either attend one of the competing universities or you're a degenerate gambler. Those are the
two
kinds of people that are crazy for March Madness.
In the world.
Last night, the Louisville Cardinals, remember we had that Kevin Ware on?
Yes.
Snapped his tibia. Oh. Well, their team won.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they beat Michigan 82-76. Here now from CBS Sports, a final recap of the tournament. Enjoy this.
They won, 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 and they won.
Not even trying. Some recap. Ladies and gentlemen, here's tonight's top ten. Let's get this done. I alluded to this earlier. It's April, a couple of days away from paying your income tax, state, local, federal, whatever you got to pay. And it's a simple lesson, and many of us have learned it by now, some the easy way, some the hard way. If you don't pay your taxes, you go to a federal penitentiary.
That's the only...
Where every day you will be beaten.
That's...
by evil guards and menacing inmates.
So please,
pay your taxes or go away for 20, 30, 50 years where every day you will be beaten.
Oh, sorry.
It's just that simple. I do and do and do for you kids, and this is the thanks I get. Hey, I wouldn't give your troubles to a monkey on a rock. Things you don't want to hear from your accountant. Things you don't want to hear from your accountant. Wow, ladies and gentlemen, here with tonight's top 10 list, 10 the New York City area accountants. Come on out, kids, and let's go. They're getting it done, ladies and gentlemen. Don't kid yourself. Things you don't want to hear from your accountant. Here we go. Number 10, Harvey Tanton. Harvey.
Take off your clothes and sit on the examining table.
I wouldn't mind that, for God's sakes, no.
You wouldn't mind that.
No. Number 9, Whitney Boyd.
Good news. You earned enough to co-sign my mortgage.
There you go. Number 8, Phil DeFalco.
My client, Wesley Snipes, said prison wasn't so bad.
There you go. Every day you will be beaten.
Don't want to hear that.
Number 7, Lawrence Spielman.
Would you like to touch my rubber thumb?
No. Number 6, Gary Schatzky.
I'm faxing over your 1099 form right now. Beep, bop, boop,
This is dumb. At number 5, Bob Menger.
Care to make a tax-deductible donation to the Taliban?
Bob. Number 4, Andrew Ross.
Give me $50, I'll make your taxes disappear.
Number 3, Sandra Bassell.
Do you have some place to stay until things blow over?
Number 2, Richard Konigsberg.
Ignore the bloodstains.
And the number 1 thing you don't want to hear from your accountant, Andrew Rubin.
Hey, nice W-2s.
Hey, what? What are you talking about? Thank you very much. God bless you, everybody. New York City accountants, area accountants. Ladies and gentlemen, when we return, Lindsay Lohan will be here, we hope. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Paul.
Anytime.
Are you ready?
Never readier.
Thank you. Our next guest is a talented actress starring in a new film entitled Scary Movie 5. I think it's a sequel.
You do, eh?
It's in theaters on Friday. Ladies and gentlemen, Lindsay Lohan.
Really, I'm Dave.
You look great. Now tell people why it is you're here tonight.
Well, I want to start by saying that I didn't think you were Dr. Phil.
Right.
I thought I was doing Fallon.
That's right. She thought she was doing Fallon, ladies and gentlemen.
And I was here early, so you do, Paul.
Yes,
yes, we've settled up.
Right,
don't worry.
So you were here early.
Just, you know, I
she
said
was.
It.
She was. I can confirm it. Yes.
The first time you were on the show was the old show at NBC. What year was it? 1986? 1992.
I was born in 86.
Yeah. Here she is on the. Look at that.
God.
Look at that. You are a Halloween costume.
I was things found on the floor of the D train.
That's right. You were dressed up as.
And there was an issue because I believe there was a condom on
the. Oh, no. Was there really on your costume?
And Lacey Chabert did it too. It was a Mean Girls with me. She was a stun gun.
Oh, she was also on that?
Yeah.
Well, you look remarkably well. Now, you know I have routinely made jokes about you and the activities, true and otherwise. You're aware of that, right?
I like that you say true and otherwise.
Yeah, yeah.
Not true and false.
True and false. Some of the activities are not true at all. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Lindsay Lohan was on the Today Show this morning. The appearance went well. Only one camera is missing.
That would be a lot for me to carry, I think.
Yeah, it would be. I mean. Now, do you routinely go around grabbing stuff?
Oh, no. Well, we thought we were going to do a joke when I came out where my tag was still on my dress, and then you had to cut it off. And
well, now, wait a minute. Who said no to that? That's tremendous.
We didn't get you in time.
Oh, no.
I was trying to pull a fast one, but, and then you were going to cut it off, and I would have said, oh, not again. I really can't cut any braces.
Yeah, but you, I mean.
But I did buy this one.
Oh, you did. But do you, you don't, yes or no, do you steal stuff?
Do you?
No.
Do you steal your cups?
No.
At the end of
you can have that. That's complimentary.
Oh, thank you. So we're done?
Lindsay Lohan's in court so often, the cafeteria has named a sandwich after her.
They don't let you eat there?
No, it's not so bad, is it?
What is this, like a gourmet course?
Yeah. Lindsay Lohan punched a psychic in a nightclub. It was right after the psychic told her, you will soon punch a psychic in a nightclub.
Set up.
Now, aren't you supposed to be in rehab now?
Do you not watch anything that goes on?
I do.
Tabloid now?
Now, here's what
May 2nd.
I was under the, May 2nd.
Yes.
And how long will you be in rehab?
3 months.
How many times have you been in rehab?
Several.
And what? How will this time be different? What are they rehabbing, first of all? What is on their list? What are they going to work on when you walk through the door?
We didn't discuss this in the pre-interview.
No, but it'll be 3 months, and
no, looking... I think to be honest, I'm the happiest when I'm working and the healthiest, and I think this is an opportunity for me to, you know, focus on what I love in life, and I don't think it's a bad thing. I think it's a blessing, and
to be able to, perhaps a lifesaver, a career saving.
Yeah. Thank you.
Now, do you have addiction problems?
Now you sound like Dr. Phil.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Is it like alcohol? Do you drink too much?
We've discussed this in the past.
Did we really? When did we discuss?
Well, because
I'm the one who's having the blackouts. What is that?
I'm just saying.
I ought to be in rehab, for the love of God. What is wrong with me? So now, when you go to the rehab, what do they do?
We have to work here for a movie.
We have to what?
Let's stay on the positive.
Oh, what?
Aside from that side of the positive.
Yeah. All right.
Come on now.
Okay, we'll talk about the movie.
I've been here since I was 7.
7 years old. How many times do you think you've been here?
I wouldn't know. I'll have to find out in rehab.
I have a list here of things that you've endured. Can I run down a few things?
Oh, can I see them first?
Yeah, go ahead. You can read them or not read them.
Okay.
Up here, the
I thought you were going to be nice.
These are the appetizers up here. These are the main courses. There's your desserts down at the bottom.
Community service hours, 560.
Yeah.
At the morgue.
At the morgue. The L.A. County morgue?
Heavy D was there when I was there. Yeah, I was at the L.A. County morgue. Let's go on to the next one.
Those are the jokes.
Oh. No, are you okay now? Are you okay now? It feels like people should be helping you. Do you have money saved? Therapy? Ask yourself, why always in trouble? I don't know. I couldn't answer that. I'm a target. I've always been. And I put myself in the past in situations where, you know, I take full responsibility for it. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't funny. And I was being immature. And I was going through a phase. And I had a lot of family stuff going on and things in life. And you grow up and you're mature. And I've said that a million times. I know that. Mm-hmm. But what else am I supposed to say when it's a process of life? And I'm not trying to deny anything that I've, any situation I've been put in.
Well, that's very nice of you to say all of this, and I'm happy for you.
But...
No, but I think you should be...
I know where this is going.
No, you don't know where it's going, but I'm saying...
No, I don't.
you're lucky that now we have this rehab that you're looking forward to.
I am. And
you're saying what you say, and you feel what you feel before you got hurt or someone else got hurt.
No, I agree.
Yeah.
I am looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to taking time for myself, and the next time I come on the show, that will be in my past, and that's the past.
Because the best way through this, the victory is to succeed and get through this and have a wonderful life ahead of you. And as what they've always told me in psychiatry, and I've done my time.
We could do our own photo together about that. That's the next cover of the post.
Yeah.
It's like this. Do it with me. I've done my time.
And I'm fine. But you know what they say, and I know you've heard this, they say, well, first we put out the fire. First we put out the fire, and then we take care of the faulty wiring.
So your mic and my hair?
No, it's... never mind. Just take care of the fire, then we get to the wiring problem.
No, I know. I've gone through a lot in life, and I'm looking forward to actually just taking time for me. Mm-hmm. You can't make a joke of it.
That's so mean. I'm not joking.
No, you're not doing that. We're not doing that.
Maybe one or two?
No, this is my show now. I'm going to come back from rehab and take over your spot.
How about just one? Just one?
I don't know.
Just not one. No. All right, you showed up. I mean, and
you showed up.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't going to.
You know, they.
Oh my God.
Well, we.
Okay. Come on, be a father figure.
All right, fine. I'm like three times your age, for the love of God. Yeah.
Sorry.
That's what, like, funny, like, dropping dead soon? Was that what it
was? No. I just hope to be in a position like you are and happy and healthy.
Well, I think you will be. That's what I'm saying. You win by taking care of your life because people are rooting against you now. They love
you. They haven't before.
Well, but so now the best way to show them that they're wrong.
No,
is
I
to
agree.
Turn it all up upside down.
Thank
on
you.
Them.
Yeah. I couldn't agree more. Mm-hmm. Stop with that pain.
We'll be right back with Lindsay Lohan, ladies and gentlemen. You're on the anger management show with Charlie Sheen. Charlie and you were friends, lifetime friends, or you became a new friend. Explain that relationship.
I met Charlie when I was doing Scary Movie 5
mm-hmm.
in Atlanta, and we discussed, you know, maybe doing. He told me about a show that he was starting to do, and he hadn't started it yet. And so it kind of all came together, and it's a really great set. It's a really nice environment. Mm-hmm. Everyone's so funny.
Did Charlie offer to give you some money or gave you money, or is that not true?
That's something you'd have to ask Charlie.
I have to ask Charlie.
Yeah.
When Charlie was off on his little trip, Did you ever say to yourself, wow, this guy's nuts?
I think he said it about himself.
Yeah.
For a minute.
And Charlie's been
He's
back
really
here.
Nice.
He's a very nice fellow and can kind of laugh about what he was up to.
But you know what's something that I think is great about someone like him is that when you're on set and the crew's there and they're working so hard day and night, he literally says thank you to everyone in the crew and says hi to everyone in the crew and really respects them. And mm-hmm. I respect that a lot. And I've always have since I was a kid. And yeah. I've had a lot of actors that I've been blessed enough to work with that have told me, and I've seen that that's something important to do. So he always like has them laughing and has them having fun. And it's a really lighthearted, just it's just a happy environment.
We've been here doing this show about 30 years, and there's still people whose names I don't know. Thank you. I know.
You didn't mean that.
I know.
Just say you didn't mean that.
Well, no, I didn't mean it. It's true, but I didn't mean it. Lindsay, let's show them a clip of the film. This opens Friday. Scary movie. You have to be in rehab May 2nd. Are you going to be there? You'll be there, right? Who's taking you to rehab? You don't want to talk about that either, right?
Oh, God. Jimmy Fallon.
Jimmy Fallon.
And you.
Jimmy and I will drive her to rehab.
And Tina Fey and Lorne Michaels.
And so when you come out, you'll...
No, but I don't want people to think that I'm making a joke of that.
No, you shouldn't make a joke.
I'm not.
Because this could be good for you. It will be good for you.
Yeah, it will.
Yeah. Have you been to this place?
No, it's not like a joking matter.
No, but I mean, but what in life can't we make light of, honestly? Really, we're all...
No,
only...
I'm fine with making light of myself. That's why I want to walk out with a tag on.
Yeah, I mean, we never thought we'd see you again, honestly, you know, because of the jokes and stuff, but yet you have enough spine, enough sense of yourself, enough poise to come out here and talk to me. All right, that's enough.
I thought this was going to be vodka.
Oh! Now, you got to stop drinking. They don't let you drink in rehab.
It was a joke.
I know. I wish you'd come out with the tags on your dress, though.
I know. It would have been so funny.
Yeah. We'll do
it's
that.
It's not
on,
funny because
that on Fallon.
It's hurtful towards me. But... No,
fun,
I love seeing you.
I love seeing you. Honestly,
I do.
It's nice. Oh,
stop.
Oh, she's tearing up a little bit. God bless you.
I love
you
too.
There you go. Let's take a look at the clip now. What is this going to be?
I believe this is the scene from Scary Movie when I'm with Charlie in the bedroom.
Mm-hmm. And he sees something that scares him. You see something that scares
him. Yeah, he actually saw what happens in the scene. I haven't seen it yet, but, oh, thanks. Let's make that obvious and all. But, no, he sees something in the scene, and there's a lot of things that happen in the scene. Sorry, I'm flustered right now because you made me screw up because you were very sweet.
I'm sorry.
Whatever, just watch the clip.
Take a look at the clip.
Whatever.
Roll it.
I don't want to end up all over the internet. I pride myself on keeping a low profile. My private life is private.
Huh.
Wait, what are all these?
Oh, just some movies I rented.
Me and Brandy, Missionary?
A Tale of Two Girls Who Become Nuns.
What are all those?
Oh, yeah, it's just your standard home security setup. Basic run-of-the-mill, no big deal, nothing too elaborate.
And why do you need security cameras pointing at your bed?
In case a burglar tries to steal my sex tapes.
Now let's get into bed.
You sure we're alone here? Feels like there's somebody else in this house. Do you hear that?
It's nothing.
Okay, what is that?
Just unraveling the old hose. Save it for tomorrow, Raul.
Si, senor.
Hey, you see, it's Scary Movie 5, ladies and gentlemen. Lindsay Lohan, God bless you. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Thank you for everything.
Thank you.
There she is.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with Pete Lee, ladies and gentlemen.
Make it a priority to catch tomorrow's Late Show with today's guests, Harrison Ford, Rita Wilson, and Jake Bugg.
Oh, hey, did I miss my thing? I'm
I'm sorry about that. Thanks for covering for me, Mike. Won't happen again.
Lindsay Lohan.
She was the greatest. She was the greatest. You gave her, you really grilled her, and she operated with the utmost poise and, you know, self-whatever.
That's right. And we've said, rarely does that happen because we have made these jokes relentlessly,
yes.
And then she's big enough, realizes and comes on and faces the music, and that was... And listen, you can see her on Anger Management Thursday night at 9:30 on FX.
Oh, great.
Lindsay Lohan, Anger Management Thursday night at 9:30 on FX. So, there you go. How many of you folks headed to rehab? Our next guest is a very funny young man. He's making his television debut with us tonight. We couldn't be happier about that. He can be seen every Friday night on VH1's Best Week Ever. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Pete Lee. Oh, Pete, come on out.
Oh. Wow, thank you. So my name is Pete Lee, and don't feel bad. I thought I was going to be Asian, too. Well, I never want anyone to feel bad. My best friend today, he said to me, he goes, dude, you're annoyingly nice. And I was like, high five. But he's right. Like, I'm your friend that I'd be like, I'm going to get your sister pregnant. And then, you know, just, like, be there for her. But I think that I'm this way because I got picked on constantly growing up because I had horrible hand-me-down clothing. It was the worst, like, seventh grade when I was the same size as my mom. That's a true story. My best friend had a leather jacket. Do you know how cool it is? I had a sweatshirt with a kitten yawning that said, I don't do mornings. Right? My mom was like, do you know what would go great with that? I'm like, yeah, karate lessons. Because right now I'm dressed in drag, but as a lady approaching menopause. Who doesn't do mornings. In eighth grade, my mom signed me up for that Big Brothers Big Sisters of America program because I had no strong male role model in my life. And you know, that ticked off was my dad. Who's an interior decorator. Yeah, my dad gave me my Y chromosome, it's just mine was in cursive. But I do have a wife who, like, exists and everything. Yeah, but her name is Jamie, and that's, like, a dude's name. Like, I have to, right? I have to be in bed with her, like, oh, Jamie, right? That's like being like, oh, Rick, right? So we started giving each other cute little nicknames. Like, she nicknamed me Pumpkin Butter Butt. Yeah, so I nicknamed her Sarah. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you. And I love my wife, but she's a New Yorker, so she likes to bust my chops, you know? She talked me into taking Pilates class with her just so she could make fun of me in front of a new group of people. We get there, she's like, yeah, my husband's here. I wear the pants in this relationship. I was like, yeah, but I wash them. And just for that little jab, I'm gonna shrink your jeans a little and make you feel fat. Thank you. I was like, either that or I'll sew your pockets shut. Because I'm a man that can sew, and that is sexy, ladies. Oh my God. Oh, I could tear your clothes off and then mend them. And there's a female bodybuilder in our class, and she makes fun of me, too. You know, I wouldn't make fun of her, but she terrorizes me. She'll be like, what's up, girly man? And I'll be like, what's up, man? Yeah, her name's Tiffany, but I nicknamed her Greg, right? But I'm pretty sure she's stronger than me because her weights are 30 pounds and my weights are purple. That's not manly at all. Like, dude, what do you bench? Violet. But I max out a magenta. And I love being married, but I'm so sick of the people in my life that have been married for way too long and they're unhappy, telling me about how scary marriage is gonna get. My grandfather's like, you know, Pete, marriage is not a sprint, it's a marathon. I'm like, well, I've run a marathon and I was only happy when it was done. Right? At least when you finish a marathon, they give you bagels, right? And a sweet t-shirt. Why don't they have that for divorcees? Like, marriage finisher. Right? Because then when all your friends are like, oh, sweetie, what happened to your marriage? You could be like, I completed it. And if I could give some advice to the new people, you're dating someone newly, don't ever tell your new person your horror stories about your ex-person. When my wife and I first got together, she was like, oh, I hate Brad. You know, like, Brad cheated on me, and he broke up with me on my birthday. And, like, one time, Brad took me to the middle of Nebraska, and he just left me there. I was like, oh, I hate Brad. If I ever see this guy, knuckle sandwich, right? But now that we've been together for like 7 long years and I realize what a miserable like she can be, I'm like, God, I love Brad. Oh. I have so many questions for this guy. Like, why Nebraska? And not Alaska. And how'd you get out, Brad? And when's her birthday?
Very nice job, Pete. Good to have you with us.
Thank you very much.
Friday nights on VH1, it's Pete Lee, everybody. We'll be right back with the Eric Clark Jr. Okay. Now, here's a guy I can remember in December. It was down in Washington. I was in Washington. Paul was in Washington. Was he was part of the Kennedy Center tribute to Buddy Guy.
Yeah.
And, oh, my God, a solitary, standalone piece of entertainment. You're not going to find any better than the performance that night.
No.
And it made me want to leave show business. Some say I have.
But I... Hello.
Thank
We're
you.
We're over here. We're over
uh-huh.
here.
Yeah. Next guest, a wonderful musician from Austin, Texas. You ever go out to that Salt Lick place out there? Oh,
Salt
my
Lick.
God.
Salt Lick.
Send me some of that stuff and then call the police.
Hello.
His new iTunes session digital album is now available. And this Saturday and Friday, or some say this Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, well, all right. Oh, normal people.
Depending on your view of the weekend.
More normal people.
Yeah. He's performing at New York's Madison Square Garden as part of Eric Clapton's Crossroads Guitar Festival. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Gary Clark Jr.
Those times I
these guys. How about them? Fantastic.
That was great.
Good to see you again, my friend. Derek Clark Jr., ladies and gentlemen.
Hello.
Madison Square Garden, Eric Clapton's Crossroads Guitar Festival, Friday and Saturday. And if you can't play guitar like that, find something else to do. Seriously. It's just not going your way. You know what I'm saying? Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Now stay tuned for Craig Ferguson. This is Al Galter speaking. Good night, everybody. My accountant is Fred Nigro. From the height of Broadway, broadcasting across the nation and around the world, it's The Late Show with David Letterman. Tonight, Lindsay Lohan, comedian Pete Lee, music from Gary Clark Jr., and a top 10 list with 10 area accountants, plus Paul Schaefer and the CBS Orchestra. I'm Al Galter. And now, Impish Toehead.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening. Welcome to the show, Hawaii My Ass. You know what I'm saying? The hit show here on CBS every Sunday night, Hawaii My Ass. What? Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful day in New York City. Isn't it lovely here? Oh. 79 degrees and sunny, like Kelly Ripa.
Ah!
You know, everything great happens here in New York City, and occasionally something weird and peculiar. You know what I'm talking about? You take your kids down to Times Square, and you're showing them around. Anybody been to Times Square? Yeah. That's where you want to spend your honeymoon. Hawaii. Who cares? So they got a guy down there, and he's his Cookie Monster, you know, the Sesame Street character, and the big Cookie Monster, and, hey, kids, come on over and have some cookies.
Yes.
And so parents say, oh, look, it's a Cookie Monster, and then the idea is you take the kid's picture with a Cookie Monster, and so that's what they did, and he's holding the kid, oh, I'm a Cookie Monster. And so then they were late. Apparently, you're supposed to tip the Cookie Monster. I had no idea. Ah, here you go. Nice job. Thanks. So dad, while mom's getting the kid back, dad's late with the gratuity for the Cookie Monster. And the Cookie Monster pushes the kid. Pushes the kid. Oh, my God. Regis, Regis, Regis. What? Man.
We're here.
We got a show for you tonight. I'm telling you, this is a show. This is why God invented TV. I'm telling you.
Tonight.
Well, we just want to do a final recap of the NCAA tournament. Did you fill out your brackets, Paul?
Fill them out?
Yeah, I got a call from the guy at NBC Sports. And he said, Dave, a lot of people, all they care about is brackets. And there's two kinds of people that really enjoy the March Madness, which, of course, is always followed by April alcoholism.
Well, I...
You either attend one of the competing universities or you're a degenerate gambler. Those are the two kinds of people that are crazy for March Madness.
In the world.
Last night, the Louisville Cardinals, remember we had that Kevin Ware on?
Yes.
Snapped his tibia. Oh! Well, their team won.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they beat Michigan 82-76. Here now from CBS Sports, a final recap of the tournament. Enjoy this.
They won, 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 and they won.
Some recap. Ladies and gentlemen, here's tonight's top 10. Let's get this done. I alluded to this earlier. It's April, a couple of days away from paying your income tax, state, local, federal, whatever you got to pay. And it's a simple lesson, and many of us have learned it by now, some the easy way, some the hard way. If you don't pay your taxes, you go to a federal penitentiary.
That's the only...
Where every day you will be beaten.
That's...
by evil guards and menacing inmates.
So please,
pay your taxes or go away for 20, 30, 50 years where every day you will be beaten.
Oh, sorry.
It's just that simple. I do and do and do for you kids, and this is the thanks I get. Hey, I wouldn't give your troubles to a monkey on a rock. Things you don't want to hear from your accountant. Things you don't want to hear from your accountant. Wow, ladies and gentlemen, here with tonight's top 10 list, 10 the New York City area accountants. Come on out, kids, and let's go.
Estate planning, retirement strategies, marriage counseling, sex therapy, vasectomy, tax preparation, vasectomy reversal, funeral arrangements, and pancakes. So stop by I Hope Is Missed a Bit Pipperfat. Come hungry, leave with a vasectomy.
Exactly what I'm talking about, you see? You know who's on the program tonight? Lindsay Lohan is on the show tonight. I believe it's part of her community service. All day long, people have been coming up to me and they're saying, Dave, why is Lindsay Lohan on the show tonight? And I said, I think she believes I'm Dr. Phil. I think that's why, she's here. If she actually shows up, I owe Paul $50. this is interesting. You know, when you're a president of the United States, when you leave office, you get your own presidential library. And the George W. Bush Presidential Library is opening the first week in May. It's fantastic. No expense has been spared on the George W. Bush Presidential Library. It's unbelievable. Watch this.
The George W. Bush Presidential Library and Museum is a premier destination for researchers, students, and families alike. The museum features over 100,000 artifacts and dozens of interactive activities that let you pretend to be the president. Trip. Bump your head. Trip again. Dodge a shoe. Drop a dog. And spit on the White House lawn. The George W. Bush Presidential Library and Museum. The only missing ingredient is you.
You see? Now we're having fun. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Paul Schaefer. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. Nice to have you here. Thank you very much.
Just ahead, a special top 10 list with 10 area accountants and Lindsay Lohan. And now, kitchen utensil shout out, whisks. Stick around.
America's mighty, mighty party and show.
going.
They're getting it done, ladies and gentlemen. Don't kid yourself. Things you don't want to hear from your accountant. Here we go. Number 10, Harvey Tanton. Harvey.
Take off your clothes and sit on the examining table.
I wouldn't mind that, for God's sakes, no.
You wouldn't mind that.
No. Number 9, Whitney Boyd.
Good news. You earned enough to co-sign my mortgage.
There you go. Number 8, Phil DeFalco.
My client, Wesley Snipes, said prison wasn't so bad.
There you go. Every day you will be beaten.
Don't want to hear that.
Number 7, Lawrence Spielman.
Would you like to touch my rubber thumb?
No. Number 6, Gary Schatzky.
I'm faxing over your 1099 form right now. Beep, bop, boop.
This is dumb. And number 5, Bob Menger.
Care to make a tax-deductible donation to the Taliban?
Bob. Number 4, Andrew Ross.
Give me $50, I'll make your taxes disappear.
Number 3, Sandra Bassell.
Do you have some place to stay until things blow over?
Number 2, Richard Konigsberg.
Ignore the bloodstains.
And the number 1 thing you don't want to hear from your accountant, Andrew Rubin.
Hey, nice W-2s.
Hey, what? What are you talking about? Thank you very much. God bless you, everybody. New York City accountant, Gary Accountant. Ladies and gentlemen, when we return, Lindsay Lohan will be here, we hope. Thank you very much. Are you ready?
Never readier.
Thank you. Our next guest is a talented actress starring in a new film entitled Scary Movie 5. I think it's a sequel.
You do, eh?
It's in theaters on Friday. Ladies and gentlemen, Lindsay Lohan. Horses! Nothing is. Guess what else? You know what's back, ladies and gentlemen? Take a guess. You know, Paul? Cicadas.
Oh, I know those things.
Cicadas are back. And this is one of those insects. Now, there's a couple of kinds. This is one of those insects that you hear that noise that drives you nuts, and they come up out of the ground every... And they have sex once every 17 years. Cicadas having sex. And I thought, great! The insects are doing better than I am. That's... They come into the city, they destroy everything, they have sex and leave. It's like Charlie Sheen, for the love of God. Hey, college basketball fans, congratulations. The Louisville Cardinals, your NCAA national champions. If you're keeping stats about this at home, this is the second time in a month that a bunch of Cardinals have gotten together and took care of business.
How about that? Yes, I remember the other time.
Oh, come on, it's all right. Quite a game. I'm going to tell you something. It's quite a game. At 1 point at halftime, and Louisville ended up winning 82-76. And CBS now has put together this highlight package of all of the exciting moments during the tourney. Hope you enjoy this. Watch.
All set for the championship matchup. Unreal. Louisville to take the lead. There's the lob to Seba. Puts up the shot.
There it was. Wonderful, wasn't it? Yeah.
We were talking to some newlyweds a minute ago, and listen to this. I don't know if you kids took advantage of this, but you can now, Denny's, the restaurant chain Denny's, has wedding chapels. So you can go in there and get the grand slam and get married, or you get married and then have the grand slam, you know? You know what I'm saying? Huh? You know what I'm saying? Well, not only can you get married in Denny's, but other restaurants, other fast food restaurants, heard about the Denny's wedding chapels and have branched out. Isn't that crazy?
It is nuts.
You're not going to believe this. Take a look.
You can now plan an affordable wedding at participating Denny's restaurants. But what happens if it's not meant to be? Come get your divorce at IHOP. And that's not all. IHOP now offers a full menu of marriage-related services,